or hear, see that you're in the class. Okay, so last time we were talking about how the Rambam writes that there's a mitzvah to believe in God, and how the Ramban, despite the fact that we didn't see it yet, but despite the fact that he's going to agree with the Rambam that there's mitzvah to believe in God, he brings down that the Bahag, the Baal HaLachot Gedolot, does not count this as a mitzvah. And they're basically struggling with the Gemara in Masechet Makot. The Gemara Masechet Makot, if we remember correctly, says, how do we know that there's 613 mitzvot? Torah Siva Lanu Moshe Marasha Kidat Yaakov. Torah Begematria 613. The Gemara S. No, it's not. It's Begematria 611. It says, okay, yeah. Torah Siva Lanu Moshe. And there's two that we heard, Mipi HaGivura. We heard them from God directly. Anochi and Lo Yiyeh. That's the Gemara in Makot. Rambam takes that Gemara very straightforward. Anochi is one, Lo Yiyeh is two. Hazago Baruch. You learn from there that Anochi is a mitzvah. Says the Rambam, the logic of the Bahag is predicated on you can't have a mitzvah to believe in God. It's a logical trap, so to speak, right? Who's commanding you to believe in God? God. Okay, so then how does that work, right? He said, right, so if we go back to the previous slide, he says, Asa kabbalat ha-malchut inyan b'fnei atzmo, v'ha-mitzvot ha-nigzarot mi'ito yed'ale mi'inyan acher. The mitzvah to believe in God's kingship is one thing, and the mitzvot that are stretched out from that are of a different nature. Okay. So then we are going to continue in the Ramban here. And he says, the only thing he has to do is now explain that Gemara and Makot according to the Bahag, because the Gemara says Anochi and Lo Yeh is the two mitzvot that are missing, right? So how does that work? So he says like this, Uleda'ato hazo, meaning the Bahag. Masha amru b'tshuvat ha-she'ela Torah, 611 have Anochi v'lo yeh m'piya givura shema'um. Lomar sheyesh b'dibur lo yeh lecha shete mitzvot. There's two mitzvot in lo yeh lecha. So which means to say, even though the Gemara says Anochi and Lo Yeh Lecha is two, it's not really Anochi is one and Lo Yeh is two, it's Lo Yeh is two. How does that work? Him, and what are these two mitzvot? Mini Abit Silamim and Lo Yeh Lecha Velo Ta'aseh. So well, let's go back to the Pisukim so we can see it in front of us. So he basically says, right, Lo Yeh Lecha is a mitzvah and Lo Ta'aseh Lecha is the same mitzvah. It's all one inclusive thing. Do not make images for yourself. And the next one is Lo Tishtahave Lahem Velo Ta'avdeh. Do not worship them. So there's two separate mitzvot here. Do not make them, do not worship them. That's how the Bahag explains. And the reason why the Gemara said Anochi and Lo Yeh, because it's all one big thing. And if you notice that at the end here, at the end of this pasuk of Lo Tishtahave, it says Leson I, which again is in the singular first person. Right? Meaning that Hashem is still talking. In which case, that's the logic of the Bahag, that if the Gemara said that we heard it from God, then it's really including all of this. Sorry, all of this, right? All this whole thing. Now, obviously, the question, the difficulty with this is that it says Anochi Eloye, right? It shouldn't have said that. And Megillat Esther is going to point that out, obviously. We didn't do any Megillat Esther yet, but God willing, today we'll get. But basically, the Megillat Esther is a commentary on the Ramban, defending the Ramban. So giving the Ramban a little bit of his own medicine, because if you remember, the Baal HaMa'or wrote a commentary on the Rif, and the Ramban wrote a defense of the Rif. So now it's sort of like someone doing to the Ramban what he did to the Baal HaMa'or, basically. Okay. And so then he says like this, continuing the Ramban, he says, right, so he says, V'hem ha-miniyah b'silamim lo yeh lecha v'lo ta'aseh lecha inyan echad v'hem miniyah b'avodah zara lo tishtachaveh lehem v'lo ta'avdeh mitzvah acheret. הודיעו כי עד כאן הדברות מפי הגבורה מובנות לכולם כאשר הם בלשון מדבר על עצמו. אנוכי, על פני, כי אנוכי, and כי אנוכי השם לקחה אל קנה, and then עושה חסד על רננת, לא הווי, ושומרי מצוותי, and there you go, that's the end of the דיבור, right? And then you finally have, לא תיסה השם השם לקחה לשם. But really, essentially, what the Ramban is saying is, that the Kavanah of the Gemara is in the Dibur Hasheni. The second Dibur, the second of the Ten Commandments, is what the Gemara's how the Gemara is mashlim the 613. Not Anochi being one and the other one being one, but rather both of them are found in the mitzvah of lo yeh and lo tavot. Okay. He says here, right, this is the Baal Halachot, v'yesh lo panim. It has a way to, you know, yesh lo panim is an expression meaning it's not as bad as, it has a way to be explained, meaning it's not bad. But then he says about od b'mitzvot lo ta'aseh, number, you know, the fifth lo ta'aseh that Harambam counts, he's going to say, ave'er ha'mitchaver li yoter, and I brought that down here, we're not going to do all of it, but basically, he says here, ha're she'be'aru pe'amim rabot ki, sorry, פעמים הרבה כי דיבור אנוכי הוא קבלת מלכותו, כלומר האמונה באלהות. אם כן, הדבר ברור הוא שדיבור ראשון ראוי למנותו מצווה ראשונה, והיא המצווה להאמין בעיקר. ונמנה לך, לא יהיה לך אחרים, הפסוק כולו מצווה לא תעשה אחת, שהיא המניעה בעבודה זרה. And then you get to 611 plus 2, which is 613. So this is our first, contradiction between Harambam and Ramban, the mitzvah ta'aseh ahad, but in reality it's not really such a strong confrontation because Harambam and Ramban actually agree, it's just that Ramban wanted to give a explanation for the Ba'ak. Now, yeah. Good? Any questions up until now? We're going to move on to our next mitzvah, which is probably the most famous machloket between the Rambam and the Ramban about De'oraita De'rabanan. But until now, any questions? Okay, next one. So we're going to go to the fifth mitzvah aseh, which is tefillah. So according to the Ramban, as we're going to see, ha-mitzvah ha-chamishit, hi shesivanu le'ovdo yit'ale, to serve God. That's how he first phrases it, is to serve God. U'kvar nechpal tzivui zeh pa'amim, and this mitzvah is already mentioned many, many times, repeated many times in the Torah. Amar, avatem et adonai lechem, ve'amar. Ve'oto ta'avodu ve'amar. Ve'oto ta'avod ve'amar ul'ovdo. Right, that's from Shema. Ul'ovdo b'chol lo'avchem. So, you see that the concept of serving God is repetitive. It's all over the place. So now the question is, so all of the mitzvot are to serve God. What does that mean? I have a mitzvah to serve God. What am I doing when I shake lulav? Isn't that part of my service to God? When I'm bringing korban? What is that? That's not part of my service to God. So here comes Harambam and says, I know you're going to think that, and therefore I shouldn't count it as a mitzvah, because it's what's called a mitzvah kolel. Okay, in his fourth shoresh, in his fourth rule that he gives in his hakdama to this book, Sefer HaMisvot, he gives 14 different rules about what is to be considered a mitzvah. The fourth one is, it's inappropriate to count as a mitzvah any statement in the Torah that's called a mitzvah kolelet, which means it talks about all the mitzvot. So you can have a mitzvah that says, keep all of the mitzvot. Ushmartem et chukotai va'asitem ota. That's not a mitzvah. That's a injunction to keep the mitzvot. So too here, he says, even though all these, right? Va'avadtem et Hashem lekechem. Ve'oto ta'avodu. Ve'oto ta'avod. Ul'ovdo. Those are not mitzvot. Those are mitzvot kolelot. Hine says, here I'm going to count it. Why? Yesh bo yichud. There is a specific thing that it's talking about, which is what? Siva betifila. Shu siva betifila. Uleshon sifre. Now, to prove his case, he's going to say that the sifre says this. Leshon sifre. Sifre is a commentary on the Torah, halachic commentary, that says ul ovdo zo tefila. Okay? What does it mean when it says ul ovdo? That means it's tefila. Ve'amru gantin v'lo ovdo. Zetalmud. In another place, it says ulovdo is to learn. Ubimishnato shel Rabbi Eliezer beno shel Rabbi Yosef Haglili amru minayin leikar tefila betoch haMitzvot. How do you know that tefila is part of the mitzvot? Meaning the 613. Mehacha et Hashem lokech atira veoto ta'avod. God, you should fear and you must serve Him. So that's answering the question. How do you know tefila is in the mitzvot? So that's clear according to Rambam. Veamru ovdehu betorato ovdehu b'mekadasho. Now, you might think to yourself, this is not a good ra'aya for the Rambam because it doesn't mention anything about tefillah. It says, ovdeo b'torato, ovdeo b'mikdasho. Serve him with Torah and serve him in the mikdash. It specifically doesn't mention tefillah. And nevertheless, Rambam goes out of its way to say, kilomar, what does it mean? To serve him in the mikdash. Lalechet sham lehit palelbo. to go to the Mikdash and to pray. It's pretty audacious, interpretation. But he says he has a proof for it, which is what? Kimo she'be'er Shlomo alav shalom melachim alef perekhet, that whole story, which is essentially that, Dibrei Yamim Bet Vav, that basically Shlomo, when he inaugurates the Bet HaMikdash, you think he builds the Bet HaMikdash, he's going to talk about all the korbanot that are going to be brought there, all this, the korbanot zibur, the korbanot yachid, the nidavat, all the different permutations and chataot and kapara and all the great things we always hear about the Bet HaMikdash, kapara, Shlomo HaMelech, if you read the Navi, he only talks about prayer. He only talks about the Bet HaMikdash being a place of prayer, not for Bnei Israel and for the nations of the world. So says Rambam, that's the Kavanah here. Okay. So that's the Rambam, pretty straightforward. And he says similarly in the Mishneh Torah, Hilchot Tefillah, Berkat Kohanim, right? Mitzvah Aseh Achat, Shem Mitzvot, one of them is, Achat La'avod Et Hashem B'chol Yom B'Tefillah. Serve God every day through the mechanism of tefillah. That's in the Koteret, in the Hakdama. And then he says, Mitzvah Taseh Lit Halacha Aleph, Mitzvah Taseh Lit Palel B'chol Yom Sh'ne'emar V'avadtem Et Hashem Elokeichem Mepi Hashimu'a. Mepi Hashimu'a means that's the tradition of what this pasuk means is, She'avozda Zo Hi Tefillah Sh'ne'emar U'lovto B'chol V'avchem Amru Chachamim Ezo Hi Avoda She'balev Zo Tefillah. So he didn't bring this statement in the Sefer HaMisvot, but he brings it in the Mishneh Torah. What is the avodah of the heart? Right. We usually understand this pasuk to mean serve God with all your heart, meaning serve God in all of your mitzvot, but do it with all your heart. That's how we're going to see the Ramban understood it. However, Rambam is understanding now. Serve God. How do you serve God? Using your heart. Your heart is the way to serve God. And that is, what do you mean? I can't bring a korban with my heart. I can't learn Torah with my heart. I can't shake lulav with my heart. What can I do with my heart? Tefillah. By the way, you see from here that kavanah in tefillah is tefillah. It's not a part of tefillah. It is the tefillah. And if you read Rambam and the Talmud also, it's mashma that way. Good.
I have a question.
Go for it.
In the Sefer HaMitzvot, it sounded like it was just the idea of praying. And then in Mishneh Torah, he says it's mitzvah to pray every day.
Very good. So, very good. So, I'm not sure if I should jump to that now. Let's do that now. Let's jump there. Hold on 1 second before we get to Hasagat Rabban here. So if we jump down to Sefer HaMitzvot, mitzvah Yud, number the 10th, which is Kriyat Shema. HaMitzvah HaAsirit Hi SheSivanu L'Kro Kriyat Shema B'Chol Yom Arvit V'Shacharit V'Hu Omro Yit'Aleh V'Dibarta Bam B'Shivtecha B'Vetecha V'Shonah U'Kvar Hitva'aru B'Shpitei Mitzvah Zo B'Masechet Berachot V'Sham Yitba'er SheKriyat Shema De'Oraita V'Lashon HaTosefta. And here comes to your point. K'Shem SheNatna Torah Keva L'Kriyat Shema Kach Netu Chachamim Zman L'Tfila Kilomar SheZmanei HaTfila Ena Mina Torah Omnam chovat ha'tefillah atzma hi manya Torah kimo shebe'arnu v'chachamim sederu la'zmani. So here in the mitzvah taseh yod, he gets a little bit more, I'll say, practical than here, which, like you're saying, it's about the idea of tefillah, so to speak. But there he specifically says, from the Torah, there's no mitzvah to pray at a specific time, but rather there's a mitzvah to pray every day. Yeah? But to jump off of your point, Teddy, the Ramban is going to pick up on some of the same, feelings of what the Ramban is saying here. He's not going to like it. He's not going to like it one bit. So he starts like this. So now we're going into the Ramban. Hasagat Ramban on mitzvah taseh he. He quotes the Rambam, that he always does that first, and he says, "Ve'en haskama baze." I do not agree with this. Shekvar be'eru ha'chachamim be'gemara tefilah de'rabbanan. He says the chachamim already made it evidently clear in the Gemarot that tefilah is de'rabbanan. Now I brought for you the Gemarot. The Ramban doesn't bring them out. Excuse me, completely, but we'll do them now. So the first one is they're really all on the same daf, but they're two different proofs. One of them is based off of the Mishnah. The Mishnah says, Ba'al keri is meharher b'libo ve'enu mevarech lo lefaneh la'achareh, right? So there's an isur. There was an isur, whether or not the isur still applies is not our problem now, but basically someone who had an emission is meharher b'libo. He's not able to pray, right? So the question really is, what is he allowed to do and what is he not allowed to do? This Mishnah is actually very complicated, and despite its brevity, but it's very complicated. But basically, meharher b'libo ve'enu mevarech lo lefaneh v'lo l'achareh seems to indicate he's meharher kriyat shema. He thinks about it, but he's not going to be mevarech before and after. Al hamazon mevarech l'acharav, on birkat hamazon he's meharher after, but he doesn't do hamotzi. Rabbi Yehuda is cholek and says mevarech lefaneh l'acharem, you do the whole thing. Good. That's the Mishnah. We don't need to get into that whole details, but the Gemara comes along and says like this, what about tefillah? Where does tefillah fall in here? All we had was Shema and Birkat HaMazon. And the Gemara asks, and it continues like this, and it says, Utnan, part of its proof, it says, Hayamed b'tefillah v'nizkar shu balkeri lo yafsik elei katze. If a person was standing in prayer, and he suddenly remembers, oh shoot, I, you know, had an emission last night or this morning or whatever, lo yafsik elei katze. He should not stop praying in the middle of the Amidah, rather shorten every single bracha. Says the Gemara, ta'amad itchil. It's only because he started. Ha lo itchil, lo yatchil. If he hadn't yet started, he shouldn't start. Says the Gemara, shani tefillah deled be malchut shamayim. The reason for this din is because tefillah doesn't have malchut shamayim, meaning to say that the reason why by tefillah we're going to tell you not to do it is because there's no inyan of malchut shamayim. However, by kriyat shema there is. Okay, that's a separate thing. And then the Gemara asks, Birkat HaMazon l'acharav deled ba malchut shamayim. Birkat HaMazon, we say it would be mevarechet, but it doesn't have malchut shamayim. So, utnan al mazon mevarech l'acharav enu mevarech l'fanav. So the Gemara says, you're right. The distinction can't be between malchut shamayim. Rather, it says, Ela kriyat shema u'birkat HaMazon de'oraita. That's why we tell you to say it in the Mishnah. And tefillah, we don't tell you to say it, right? Ha'lo yatchil, lo yatchil. U'tfillah de'rabanan, which means to say, the reason why a Baal Keri doesn't do it, tefillah, is because it's the Rabbanan. The reason why he does do Shema in Birkat HaMazon is because it's the Oraita. Seemingly a very, very nice proof for the Ramban that tefillah is only a Rabbanan. Similarly, a little bit further down the page on Masechet Brachot, we have a statement, Amar Rabbi Yehuda, Safek Kara Kriyat Shema, Safek Lo Kara,
so this is a radical shita, radical because we're not used to it. But basically, he says if a person is not sure if they said Shema, he doesn't have to go back.
And if a person is not sure if he said Emet ve'yatziv, he must repeat that bracha. Okay? Says the Gemara, Ma'itama, what's the reasoning? Kriyat Shema d'Rabbanan, Emet ve'yatziv de'oraita. Right? So Rav Yehuda holds this. Wild position, but that's what he holds. Metiv Rav Yosef argues and says, "Ufshoch bechav kumecha, habibi." It's a pasuk. Amar le'abaye ha'u b'divrei Torah k'tiv. That's divrei Torah. That's ufshoch bechav kumecha about learning Torah, not about saying Shema. Okay, so you have to. By the way, in parentheses, that means that Rav Yehuda really has to explain a lot of Mishnayot that seem to indicate that B'shoch B'chav Kumecha is the Mekor for Shema, right? The Machloke Bet Shemayah Bet Hillel, but how do you have to say it? What position? You're using B'shoch B'chav Kumecha, but fine. We'll, for another day. Tanan, Baal Keri Merheb Yidlo Benu Mechlech Lo Lefenev L'Acharea, Baal Mazom Mevrech L'Acharea Benu Mevrech L'Fanah, Bisa Kadatah Emet V'Yasiv Deoraita Livroch L'Acharea. So the Gemara says, how could you tell me that Emet V'Yatziv is Deoraita, if the Mishnah tells me a Baal Keri doesn't have to say Emet V'Yatziv, and he has to say Shema. Ma'ita Ma Mevarech, so the Gemara says, why would I be Mevarech? What's the point of being Mevarech? Because of Yitziat Mitzrayim? Question mark. Ha'idkar le'b'r Kriyat Shema. I don't have to do it because I said in Kriyat Shema, meaning to say, since I fulfill the Chiyu for, meaning like this, since the reason why I have to say Emet V'Yatziv and there's a Chiyuv De'oraita to say Emet V'Yatziv is because of Yitziat Mitzrayim, to mention Yitziat Mitzrayim, I also accomplished that in my Drabbanan obligation for Shema. Therefore, I only have to say Shema. So the Gemara asks the obvious question. So why don't you say Emet Yatziv, and then you wouldn't need to say Shema, right? Emet Yatziv is a much greater proclamation of Yitzhiyah Mitzrayim than Shema. So just say that one, and then you don't need to say Shema. Says the Gemara, Kriyat Shema Adifa Di'it Batarte. Kriyat Shema has two things. It has a mention of Yitzhiyah Mitzrayim, and it has Yichud Hashem and Limud Torah and all that stuff. So therefore, it's better. Therefore, we're going to say Shema. But really, the logic is that Shema is a Deoraita, and that's why, Shema is a Derabanan, and that's why I don't need to repeat it. But Emet Yatziv is a Deoraita, and that's why if I had a Safek, I would have to repeat. Good. That's all a setup for this next line. Rabbi Elazar Omer, Safek Kara Kriyat Shema, Safek Lo Kara, Chozer Vekore Kriyat Shema. Because, as Rashi HaMispat says, because he holds Kriyat Shema is Deoraita, Safek Itpalel, Safek Lo Itpalel, Eno Chozeru Mitpalel. If you have a doubt whether or not you pray or not, you don't have to go back and pray. Seemingly the same logic as above, right? Because Kriyat Shema deRabbanan Emet Yatziv deOraita. Now just change the terms. Kriyat Shema deOraita Tefillah deRabbanan. Rabbi Yochanan Amar Vilavai Shiyitpalel Adam Kol Yom Kulo. Rabbi Yochanan's famous shita is, I wish that everyone would pray the whole day. Meaning to say, oh, you had a safek, so pray again. What's the problem, right? So that's the Gemara, again, proving according to the Ramban that Tefillah is deRabbanan because of this line here. Safek Yitpalel, Safek Lo Yitpalel, Eno Chozer Mitpalel. If it was a deOraita, how could you say you don't have to be Chozer Mitpalel? Good. We're going to see one other Gemara. It's Masechet Sukkah. Says the Gemara like this, the Mishnah. Very important Mishnah. Mi sheba baderech velo haya biyado lulav litol, lekishikanes lebeto yitol ha-shulchano. Okay? If a person is coming home from traveling, and he didn't have a lulav with him, so he couldn't have done the mitzvah of lulav, when he gets home, yitol ha-shulchano. Right? He should be notel the lulav, al shulchano here means, even if he has to interrupt his meal, meaning to say, even if he has to be notel the lulav on his shulchan. That's the resha of the Mishnah. Sef of the Mishnah says, lo natal shacharit, yitol ben arvaim, shekol hayom kasher lulav. If you forgot to be notel the lulav in the morning, so do it in the afternoon, because the whole day is kasher for the mitzvah of lulav. Gemara, amart notla shulchano. You told me in the beginning, notla shulchano, meaning to say, I interrupt my meal. Lememra de mafsik, that means to tell me that he has to interrupt his meal, stop his meal, to do the mitzvah of lulav. Says the Gemara, urminhu. The Mishnah in Masechet Shabbat tells us, im hitchilu en mafsikim. Okay, for those of us who didn't learn it, look at Rashi, im hitchilu en mafsikim. Gabe tefilat hamincha tnan la b'masechet Shabbat. Lo yishev adam lefnei ha-sapar, lo yikanes lo lechol, lo ladum, v'im hitchilu kodem mamincha, u'mashcha seudatan, v'igi hazman mamincha, en mafsikim. If you are involved in any of these things, one of them being eating a meal, and you got involved in those things before the zman of mincha, and now it's time for mincha, you don't need to stop your meal. I don't need to stop my meal so I could pray mincha. So how come when it comes to lulav, I say, stop your meal and be notel lulav, and by here, I say, and by tefillah, I say, you don't have to stop. Says the Gemara, Amar Rav Safra, lo kasha hadi ikashut bayom, hadele kashut bayom. Comes along Rav Safra and says, no, it's not a problem. One of the cases is that there's a time left in the day for you to do it, meaning to say, I don't need to stop because I have plenty of time to do it. And the other case is that mincha is going to be over in 30 seconds or whatever, 5 minutes, so I need to stop my meal right now. Or vice versa, I don't need to stop my meal. Says the Gemara, Amar Rava says, why are you doing that? Why are you saying that the cases are not comparable when there's a much easier answer to give? What is it? Dilma ha deoraita veha drabana. One is deoraita, netilat lulav, and ha is drabana. And then Rava has to give a whole new explanation for the Mishnah, but that is our starting point. The Gemara takes that and goes with it such that at the end of the day, right, it ends up saying, right, so meaning to say, if it weren't for that, it would have a problem. If he wasn't ma'amid our Mishnah as being a case of Yom Tov Sheni Midrabanan, this would have been the answer, which seems to tell you that guess what? Lulav might be a drabanan, but for sure what's a drabanan is tefillah, according to this understanding of this Gemara. So good. All right. I put on the bottom here. So these are the Gemarot, and now comes along, continues the Ramban in his Hasaga. So up until in the beginning, the Ramban just quotes the Gemarot that are evidence that tefillah is only a chiyuv midrabanan. And he continues like this. וכבר ראינו בהלכות תפילה שאמר שחייב אדם מן התורה בתפילה בכל יום אלא שאין מניין התפילות ולא משני התפילות תפילה מן התורה וכך כתב. This is how he wrote הרמב״ם. במצווה עשירית, right in the 10th מצווה, שזמני התפילה אינה מן התורה והחובת תפילה עצמה היא מן התורה. וגם זה איננו נכון בעיניי. So he quotes הרמב״ם in the מצווה עשירית and he says that's not true in my eyes. Meaning the Rambam's entire framework is incorrect, says the Rambam. This is the Ramban. This entire understanding that tefillah is deoraita and all the details of tefillah are drabanan, not good. Disagrees. And now he's going to say why. Oh, we did that. We jumped a little. That's why these slides are a little out of order. Okay. So continuing with the Ramban, and now he's going to pile on attack after attack after attack onto the Ramban. After already he proved from the Gemarot that tefillah is drabanan. He says like this. How do I know another way? Tefillah is drabanan? He says very simply, Ba'al keri mevarech al amazon le'acharav mipnei shehu min haTorah ve'eno mitpalel an sheyitbol afilu amad kama yamim bekiryo. A ba'al keri is mevarech al amazon. He does berkat amazon, but he's not allowed to pray for many days until he does tefillah. So what does that tell you? Tells you that even though he's a Baal Keri, we tell him, well, you got to say Birkat HaMazon. But because he's a Baal Keri, he doesn't pray, even though he's going to go many days, perhaps, without being Tovel, and then hence not praying. How come we don't care about that, says the Ramban, if it's an Isur Deoraita, if it's a Mitzvah Deoraita? He says another question. He says, Mishin Ne'enas, Velo Yitpalel Shacharit, Ube Mincha, Nistapek Be'atzmo, Safek Yitpalel, Safek Lo Yitpalel, Imken, Lefi Devarav, says the Ramban, you hold that it's a mitzvah to pray. Okay? So let's say a person didn't pray Shaharit, and now he's misupak about whether or not he prayed Mincha. According to you, he needs to pray today, and he's not sure whether he did. How come you don't tell him he has to pray again? He should. Instead, you are posek. Anytime safek yitpalel, you don't have to pray again. Why not? Let's say that would have been your only prayer for the day. It's a chiyuv deoraita. Question. V'im enena mitzuveh b'chol yom, and if you tell me the answer is, you know what, it's not a mitzvah every single day. Matay tiyeh achovah hazot hu mutelot alav alenu min haTorah sheyitpalel yom echad b'shana o b'chol yamav pam achat. When is it? You pray once a year, you pray once in your entire life. Now, we might not get to the Megillat Esther today, but he's basically going to say, this is not a fair question on the Rambam. You're choosing not to read the Rambam. The Rambam specifically said there's a mitzvah once a day. Okay, so that means that you have to answer the question that Rambam just asked, which he will. Good up until now?
Yeah.
Okay, moving forward, he even says like this: Kvar amru b'Rav Yehuda demitlatin yamin letlatin yamin have a matzleh. Rav Yehuda, and this is not the only one here. He would pray once every 30 days. Why? Lefishaya osek b'Torah v'salmecha masha amru chaverim shayu oskim b'Torah mafzikin lekriat shema ve'en mafzikin l'Torah lechid rabanan le'olam. Hazaku Baruch, says the Ramban. Look, we have instances of the Gemara in the Gemara where the rabbis didn't pray. What are you going to tell me? What could you possibly tell me? The rabbis did not pray for 30 days. What could you possibly say? Ulam badai kol inyan tefillah eno chova klal aval hu mimidot hachesed habore yitbarach alenu sheshomea veone bechol koreinu elav ve'ikar. Okay, now he has to answer all the ra'ayot that the Rambam brought, and he says like this: ve'ikar hakatuv ulovdo bechol levavchem. What does it mean, ulovdo b'chol levavchem? Mitzvat aseh shetie kol avodoteinu el yibarach b'chol levavenu, kelomar b'kavana rutzuya shelema lishmo ube'ayin hirhur ra. Lo shenaseh ha-mitzvot b'lo kavana o ha-safek ulayesh b'hem tohelet. What does it mean, ulovdo b'chol levavchem? The way we normally understand it, serve him with pure intention, serve him with all your heart, with all your passions, with all your energies. Ke'inyan v'ahavta adonai lecha b'chol levavcha v'chol namshicha v'chol me'odecha, just like, you know, v'ahavta et Hashem elokecha. Shem mitzvah hi le'ehov et Hashem b'chol lev. Da, da, da. Umashidarshu besifre. Okay, now you have to do ulov do zot talmud devaracher zot tefillah, which the Rambam brought, right? Just to bring that down here, right? Ulov do v'amru besifre, ulov do zot tefillah. Right. So, what are you going to answer to that? Says the Ramban. Where is it? Oh, here we go. Umashidarshu besifre, ulov do zot talmud devaracher zot tefillah. Excuse me. Devar acher zot tefillah. Sorry. Asmachta he answers the Ramban. It is an asmachta. It's not a chiyuv. It's just giving an asmachta to tefillah midrabanan. Olomar, or another possibility is to say shemeklal haavodah shenilmod Torah v'shenitpalel alav be'et hasarot. Okay, says the Ramban. Or it could be saying that the service includes learning, but also, and here comes his own opinion, really. Shenitpalel elav be'et hasarot etiena enenu v'libenu elav levado ke'ene avadim el yad adonehem. Right, that we pray to him, that there's a mitzvah to pray to him at moments of crisis. V'zeh inyan shekatuv ki tavo milchama v'artzechem al saros roetchem v'hare'otem b'chasos erot v'nizkartem lefnei Hashem l'klechem. V'hi mitzvah, and here comes Ramban, al kol sara v'sara shetavo al ha-sibur l'sok v'fanav b'tfilah u'b'tru'ah v'hu inyan shebe'er shlomo. So basically, the Ramban would say, Hazak Baruch, that there's no mitzvah of praying every day, but, you know, nowadays, we'll give an example, Corona days, there is a mitzvah every day to pray, because you're in a sar ha-saret, you're in a, you're in a crisis situation, you're in a emergency situation, and there's a mitzvah in emergency situations to reach out to God. Not it's because there's a mitzvah of tefillah, because there's a mitzvah that extends from hare'otem b'chatzotzorot, from v'nizkartem lifnei Hashem l'okechem. And he says, the Rambam is so keen on bringing Shlomo HaMelech. Look at what Shlomo HaMelech actually said in when he built the Beit HaMikdash. He says, when are you going to pray? B'he'aser ha'shamayim le'yematar. Uchtiv, right? When there's no rain. Uchtiv ra'av ki yehyeh, dever ki yehyeh, shidafon yirakon arbe hasil ki yehyeh. There you go. Notice what Shlomo HaMelech includes in the prayers. All these bad things. But how come he didn't say, and on a day where you just wake up and want to pray to God? Says the Ramban. It's not a mitzvah. That's why. It's not what he was doing. He built the Beit HaMikdash so that people could come and pray their chiyuvim deoraita when they have problems. Ukvar darshu od sham besifre Rabbi Elazar ben Yaakov omer ulovdo b'chol levavchem chonem shechem ma talmud amar v'alo kvar ne'emar b'chol levavchem chonem shechem v'chol me'odecha. Answers the Gemara. Answers the sifre. Lahan lan yechir v'kan l'sibur v'kan l'tamud kan l'maaseh. The sifre asks the question. Why does it tell me ulovdo b'chol levavchem chonem shechem? When we know it says b'chol levavchem chonem shechem. Right? I don't think b'chol me'odecha is probably the proper thing. Okay, either way. V'halan yachid, v'kan le'sibur. This is an individual, right? It's singular. And the other one is collective. Kan le'talmud. One of them is talking about talmud, learning. And one is talking about doing. Which means to say, Yomar, shenistaveno l'avod Hashem yitbarach b'chol levavenu b'limud torato u'ba'atziyah asiyat mesvotav. Right, and which is the much more pshat, right? If you go back to the Rambam in the Sefer HaMitzvot, right? Avdehu b'torato, avdehu b'mikdasho. Rambam had to say, kilomar, what does it mean to worship him in his mikdash? To go there to pray. Rambam says, what are you doing? What are you doing, right? It's much more pashut to say, Ovdeh v'tor ovdeh v'mikdasho perusho lomar shi'avdu oto v'mikdasho ba'avodat ha'korbanot v'ashir v'ashtechavaya sham. Good. Fine. Let's see. So he says here, Hine asiyat ha'mitzvat kulan kvar ne'emar l'kach darshu v'oto t'avod ba'avodat v'mikdash v'amiru b'firush klal ha'pasuk avodu b'torato avodu b'mikdasho lomar shesiva techila avodu b'torato l'kilomar ba'asiyat ha'mitzvot kulan mireshah dekra v'siva avodu b'mikdasho mean ve'atata ve'otot avot. He's explaining how the pesukim work. Fine. Right, so then he has to explain because he has to get to that. He says here. He says that's why, right? In order to, you know, keep these as mitzvot, right? You'll have to say that the Rambam, even though it's a mitzvah kolelet, he'll have to count it once because it is something new. It's just not saying, meaning he doesn't count the mitzvah kolel when the pasuk doesn't add anything. Here, the pasuk is adding something. It's adding the inyan of serving God with all your heart. In which case, even though it says it multiple times, you would have to count it once. And therefore, he's saying that's how I would, even though I'm getting rid of, quote unquote, the mitzvah of tefillah, if I need to replace it with something, I would replace it with this. And that's why it's not a problem of counting a mitzvah kolel. But now he says like this, ve'ulam im chadash bekfilan. Okay, right, okay, we did that. Ve'im ulai yeh midrasham betfilah ikar. Or maybe you'd say, maybe the midrash, the sifre, is actually talking about ikar, tefillah, right? That's the ikar. When it says, olavdo b'chol vavchem, zo tefillah, what does it mean? Nimne oto b'minyano shel harav, v'nomar shehi mitzvah le'et sarot. I could count it, just like Harambam counted it as a mitzvah. However, it would only be mitzvah le'et sarot shena'amin shehu yitbarach v'yitale shomea tefillah. Which would mean to say, I would count not tefillah as a mitzvah, I would count leaning on God or reaching out to God in a moment of crisis as a mitzvah. It's a mitzvah that in a moment of crisis to reach out to God. And that would, quote unquote, replace the mitzvah de'oraita of tefillah. Good, so we have a fundamental machloket, Rambam and Ramban, and it's very, very, ooh, that's a bad typo. Can't do that. It's the best. Can't leave that like that. I apologize. Fundamental machloket Ramban. It pops up all over the place. Although, as we're going to see from the Megillat Esther, which might not be able to finish today, practically it might not have so many implications. So let's just start here. Obviously, the Megillat Esther and Seg opens up and says, Nirali. Right, the Rambam is right. Just like the pshat of the Sifre says, now he has to address all of the Ramban's claims. Before we go, does anyone have any answers to any of the Ramban's claims? Any one that you remember that you want to give an answer for? Anyone even here?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't have an answer though.
Shomer's gone. Okay, fine.
Yeah.
I'm here. Okay, fine. Masha Amar Haramban, Kimashe Keluba Bemekomot Rabim Nirashihi Midrabanan. So, right, the Ramban, one of his main points was that they treated it, in the Gemara, treated it as a mitzvah de Rabanan. Ani Omer. Shebechol makom shehizkiru tefillah derabanan. Anytime they said tefillah derabanan safek al yitpalel, retonam al nosach tefillah shetiknu lana. They're talking about what's colloquially known in the Ashkenaz world as the Shemona Esrei. They're not talking about tefillah, one of the 613. They're talking about praying your Amidah today. Shemina Torah, kol echad ve'echad yachol yitpalel kifi da'ato bebakashat zerachav lishpoch sichol lefnei Hashem bederech shiyatav ve'enav. According to the Torah, a person could just get up, say a nice formula, that Hashem, you're the creator of the universe, I really need your help in providing for my family. Thank you for everything you've done. Yatzai yidechova tefila medeoraita. However, the Chachamim come along and say, we're going to create the Shemona Esrei. And the Shemona Esrei, the Amidah, is what the Gemara says when it says Tefillah is Rabbanan. Therefore, any time the Gemara says Tefillah Rabbanan, it's referring to the Amidah that you're about to pray, or the you know, the Safek. Should I? What do you mean? don't pray again. Don't say another Amidah. But it doesn't mean if you didn't fulfill your obligation of Deoraita yet, don't pray. Of course pray. Just don't say another Amidah. Because that's only the Rabbanan. And that was the Ramban got all jammed up about. Shekhatab b'chibur agadok his manei atifilayin min ha-Torah v'amar she'imken en chiyuv min ha-Torah litpalel b'chol yom matayi yechayav. Right? The Ramban is, if Torah, if the, well, what do you pray once in a year, once in your entire life, right? And he said that really wasn't a fair question. He says, nirali shelo hishkiach al debre harav. He really just didn't read the words of the Ramban carefully. Shareu katav b'berur mitzvah aseh litpalel b'chol yom. According to Rambam, it's barur that it's b'chol yom. Harei she'amitzvah b'chol yom, v'im katav v'achar kach she'zmanei tefilah ena min ha-Torah, perusho she'en zmana kavua be'eze sha'a min ha-yom yitpalel ki min ha-Torah, harashut b'yado yitpalel be'eze sha'a she'yotze, elach che'chachamim tiknu la'zmanim zmanei ha-kravat ha-temidim, zeu perush tefilot keneged temidim k'tiknum, lefi ma she'katav ha-migdal oz b'tchilat v'chol tefilah v'chibur. Okay, fine. Good. I didn't need to translate that, yeah?
Good.
Good. Gam Masha Amar Rav Yehuda, that he, right? Very good, Re'aya, that Rav Yehuda wouldn't pray every 30 days. Huh. Get out of that one, Rambam, right? So what does he say? Yeah, that's also. It means he wouldn't pray the Amidah every 30 days. But Vadai, Rav Yehuda would say a tefillah because it's a mitzvah deoraita. It's a mitzvah deoraita. Of course he wouldn't go without praying, right? It's just because the Amidah is very long, and this guy's learning all day. So he is patur from saying the Amidah. He can fill his Midoraita of Tefillah with another shorter request. Okay? Haya bevadai haya mitpalel b'chol yom, haya mekatzer ba mipnei alimud, ma she'amar od, ki drashat ha-sifre hi asmachta, ani omer she'en lo shum raya. He says it's an asmachta. I say, where does he get that from? Right? It's just his opinion, essentially, right? You say it's an asmachta. I say it's not an asmachta, right? What are you going to do? Right? All the things, all his other proofs from the Gemara, we're not there. Right? He says it's only if I take the if I don't treat it as an asmachta and I take it as a real drasha, then I'll tell you it's only a mitzvah and etzara. Ani umer shalze kvar nistavenu b'turat ha-chatzotzrot. That's already a mitzvah below the chatzotzrot. Od ki baze a pasuk lo skuru chatzotzrot umina leli tenet ha'amur shel ze baze. Right? And in the pasuk of ulovdo b'chol levavchem, it doesn't mention chatzotzrot. So you're telling me, oh, ulovdo b'chol levavchem zot tefilah, says the Ramban. If that's a real drasha, then I'll tell you that that really has to do with chatzotzrot. Ikar chaser min ha-sefer u'ma she'amar od ki kvar darshu b'sifre b'ze ha-pasuk drasha acheret lavor ra. Hine en mikan teshuva al harav shelo lakach zot ha-drasha ki kol echad tefas ha-drasha ha-mityashevet b'enav yoter b'pshat ha-pasuk. Says the Megillat Esther, his last point is basically that he brought another sifre that contradicts, that gives another perush of ulovdo b'chol levavchem. La'avod et Hashem, sorry. Shehi la'avod et Hashem b'chol levavenu b'limud Torah v'asiyat mitzvah. He says, okay, en mikan teshuva da. Why? Shelo the Rambam was using a different drasha. There are different drashot. The Rambam went with one. You're going with another. Okay, but guess what? The Rambam still stands on good ground. And that doesn't contradict what the Rambam says. It's an added layer. Uma she'amar od ki ma she'amru ba'avdeo b'miktasho en perusho b'tfilah, hine en lo shum ra'ya b'zeh v'da'at harav perusho b'tfilah. Again, essentially, the Megillat Esther just says, the Ramban is being mifaresh these things in his own way that serves his own opinion. And the Rambam was mefaresh differently. There's no way to prove, right? Of Deo b'mikdasho, he says, it's not, doesn't mean tefillah, says the Rambam. It does mean tefillah. So there you go. So it's a little bit of a just a once you get past the rayot from the Gemara, this actually continues a little bit, but it goes on a little bit of a tangent, so I didn't bring the whole thing. But basically, that's the defense for the Rambam, that basically any time the Gemara mentions a Tefillah Drabanan or Safek Yitpalel, Al Yitpalel, anything like that, it's because what it's talking about is the Amidah. I think this is, aside from the importance of this machloket for limud purposes, to be able to be in the inyanim, to understand. I think it's a very important machloket, because we're going to be posek like the Rambam. We are posek like the Rambam, and we treat tefillah as being a deoraita, which has huge implications, both for women praying, for safeks, for all sorts of things. But I don't think we really treat tefillah as a deoraita. We treat it seriously, but as I said before, think about where it's all being learned out from. It's being learned out from ulovdo b'chol levavchem ezohi avodah shebelev zoi tefillah. Tefillah equals kavana. Kavana is the essential nature of tefillah, and that is the deoraita, right? You don't have to kavana. You weren't yotzei your mitzvah deoraita. I mean, personally, I've gone many days where I've just been like, yeah, I've prayed 3 tefillah today, but I didn't have kavana in anything. And I just lost an opportunity at a mitzvah deoraita. It's a very serious problem. And so I just think that it slips our attention a lot that every mitzvah, every time we stand up in the Amidah, and by the way, if you hold that mitzvot tzirichot kavana, you have to have kavana for this. You have to have kavana that I'm about to be mekayem a mitzvah deoraita. Very fundamental machloket, very important machloket, and Bezrat Hashem, next week, I believe the next one on the docket is whether or not there's a mitzvah to swear in Hashem's name. According to Ramban, it might be Isur. According to Ramban, it might be a mitzvah. So that's a pretty extreme machloket. I believe that's next on the docket. I have to just check, double check on that. Okay, guys.
Wait, one last question.